That n choose r and n choose n minus r are equal by showing that they both counted the same number of objects. And such a proof is called a combinatorial proof. Another important theorem that can be shown combinatorially in a couple of other ways as well is called Pascal's identity. All right, so I want to make the point real quick that Pascal's theorem is not originally known to Pascal. This is an example of the European colonization of mathematics. At least Chinese mathematicians in the 1300s knew it, which is about 300 years before Pascal started writing. Okay, well, here is the theorem referred to as Pascal's identity. It says that n choose r is equal to n minus 1 choose r minus 1 plus n minus 1 choose r. And the idea is that this is a recurrence relation among the binomial coefficients, right? In order to know n choose r, I just need to know two of the coefficients that come before it. It's not quite a sequence because it relies on two different inputs, but it's the same basic idea. All right, so let's do an example to see why Pascal's identity might be true. There's a video coming up where we go through a few different proofs of it, but right now we can just kind of convince ourselves that it might be true. So we're going to enumerate all of the three element subsets of the set A, B, C, D, E to find out what 5 choose 3 is. And I'm going to group them a certain way. So here are my three element subsets of A, B, C, D, E. I can do the obvious one, right? A, B, C. I can also do A, B, D. I can also do, you think I'm going to write A, B, E next, but I'm not. I'm going to write A, C, D. There's a reason for this, I promise. And then I'm going to write B, C, D. So that's going to be some of my subsets. I could also have A, B, E. I could have A, C, E. I could have A, D, E. By now you know I'm going to do the E's in red, so I'm going to skip that and just do them all at once. I could do B, C, E. I could do B, D, E, and I could do C, D, E. All right, so there's a reason I laid the subsets out like this. Notice that all of these subsets are subsets of A, B, C, D. I didn't need the E to make these subsets. I just needed A, B, C, and D. And so there are going to be 4 choose 3 of these. And we saw in the previous video that 4 choose 3 is 4. Of course, you can also just count the subsets. Meanwhile, all of the subsets that contain the E are subsets of A, B, C, D with E added. And so these are all two element subsets that I added E to. So there's going to be 4 choose 2 of these, and there's 6 of these. And so let's figure out what 5 choose 3 actually is. I mean, it's clear that it's 10, right? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 sets here. Let's see that the formula for 5 choose 3 gives us that. 5 choose 3 is 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 2 factorial. I can rewrite this as 5 times 4 times 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 2 factorial. 2 factorial is just 2, and so that gives me 10. So we can see here that 5 choose 3 is 4 choose 2 plus 4 choose 3, which is exactly what Pascal's identity says it's going to be. One of the main uses of Pascal's identity is that it lets us represent the binomial coefficients visually in a very convenient way. So I'm going to draw a triangle where every row of the triangle represents a value of n starting at 0 and ticking down, or ticking up, but visually ticks down. And then from left to right, I'm going to have r going from 0 to n. All right, the top of the triangle represents 0 choose 0, which is 1. The next row has 1 choose 0 and 1 choose 1. I'll leave it up to you to verify using the formulas that these are all equal to 1. This is 2 choose 0 and 2 choose 2, right? You can figure out that there is only one empty set and there's only one full set. Every other number I'm going to get using Pascal's identity. Pascal's identity says that n choose r is the sum of n minus 1 choose r minus 1 plus n minus 1 choose r. So I'm going to add the two numbers above it. 1 plus 1 is 2, which gives me 2 choose 1. All right, then I'm going to call it the third row because it corresponds to n equals 3, even though it's technically the fourth row. 3 choose 0 is 1. 3 choose 3 is 1. 1 plus 2 is 3, that's what 3 choose 1 is. And 2 plus 1 is 3, that's what 3 choose 2 is. The fourth row is 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. And so again, the idea is that 3 plus 3 makes 6, and that's using Pascal's identity. Then we get 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1, 1, 6, 15, 20, 15, 6, 1. And so I can very quickly calculate the binomial coefficients using this recurrence relation in this thing that's called Pascal's triangle. And here is Pascal's triangle for the first 11 rows.